I'm so sorry if I interrupted you.
Ren, how'd you get away from the train?
I might ask you the same thing.
We jumped.
We're still a long way from Paris. How unfortunate this turn of events has been. For the plague victim, of course.
It's awful. The Grateful Wolf was with me.
Wolf? What an unusual name. Did your parents give it to you?
Does it matter?
Do you two know each other? Your nails. Roll up your sleeve.
I beg your pardon?
Now.
As you wish.
LSOP-1126. Tattooed across his forearm.
Scarlet, this is Ren Kesley, a loyal soldier to the Order of the Pack. Don't worry. He is only an Omega.
You could smell him on me. When I came out to the car, you knew. And you knew he was following us this whole time. How?
What exactly have you told her, brother?
She knows I'm no longer a brother to you. And she knows that no one with that mark can be trusted.
Is that all?
I know you have my grandmother.
Well, not with me.
Why are you following us?
I've been sent to retrieve my brother. Perhaps he did not tell you that he and I are a part of an elite pack given a special assignment. That assignment has been canceled, and our master wants us to return. All of us.
I'm not coming back.
I doubt that. And you know as well as anyone that we don't allow our brothers to leave us. Though, I confess, I haven't missed having one less alpha around.
Do you really think it's wise to come here?
I think you'll find me somewhat improved, Alpha.
Is this why you followed us? You saw your chance to improve your rank? To defeat me away from the pack?
I told you why I'm here. The assignment is canceled. When he finds out about this rebellion of yours...
Wolf launched at Ran, knocking him onto his back with a sickening crunch.
No! Stop! He might be able to tell us something!
But they continued to fight. The bullet had barely grazed his arm, but it got his attention.
Did you just shoot me?
He didn't leave much choice. He could tell us something. He could help me get my grandma back.
He won't talk.
How do you know?
I know.
That's not good enough.
I will kill you one day, brother.
Stop provoking him.
Ran closed his eyes as he took slow, rattling breaths.
I'm sorry I shot you. But you were going to kill him.
I still might.
Is he your real brother? Wolf?
I never said we got along.
Good. You must know his weaknesses. You know best how to question him.
We're trained to withstand questioning. He won't help us.
How do you know?
I know Ran. He would do anything to improve his standing. By tracking me down and forcing me to return, or even showing proof that he fought me and won, he hoped to do just that.
When he first told me about leaving the pack, I thought maybe it had been months or even years. But Ren made it sound like you had just left. Wolf?
It's been less than 3 weeks.
About the time my grandmother disappeared, he told me you were a nobody. But Ren called you an alpha. Isn't that a pretty high rank? And now you told me you left them around the same time my grandmother was kidnapped. We had no idea why they would take my grandmother, but that was a lie, wasn't it?
Scarlet.
So it was true. Did you really leave them? Or is this all some story to get me to... Am I the mission Rand was talking about?
No.
After my dad warned me about this, he said one of you would come for me, and there you were, and I even knew you were one of them, but I couldn't trust you, and I still let myself believe...
Scarlet, stop. You're right. I lied to you about not knowing why they took your grandmother. But you aren't the mission Ran was talking about.
It has something to do with my grandmother.
It has everything to do with your grandmother. I'm sorry. I knew that if I told you, you wouldn't trust me. I know I should have anyway, but... But I... couldn't.
Tell me everything.
You're going to despise me.
Lunars knew how to cloak their spacecrafts, or so Cinder had heard, and they needed to re-enter the atmosphere undetected. So cloaking she would try, not that she was sure how.
Hide, Rampian. Disappear. Fade away. You do not exist. You cannot be seen.
Is it working?
I have no idea. Do you feel any different?
No, still gargantuan. How long will I have to stay like this?
I don't know. Until we can install another auto-control system.
And until you can find me a new body.
That, too.
I don't like being a ship. It makes me feel less alive than ever.
Hey, Cinder! You watching the net?
Can't you see I'm busy?
Yeah, good one. In the meantime, you should watch this. They're talking about us on all the channels. We're famous.
No thanks. I'd rather not see myself acting like a maniac at the most important social event of the year.
They already showed the clips. And now you've achieved the dream of every red-blooded girl under the age of 25.
Oh, yeah. My life is a real dream come true.
Maybe not. But at least Dreamy Prince Kai knows your name.
Emperor Kai.
Precisely. They're starting a press conference to talk about you. Thought you wouldn't want to miss his heavenly chocolate brown eyes and perfectly tousled hair and... Ow! What's got your wires crossed?
Adjusting the channel now. He looks so handsome today.
Thanks, Aiko. Sound on.
Everything we can to find the escaped convicts. The ship they're in is not meant for extended periods of orbit. Eventually, they will have to return to Earth, and we'll be ready for them.
My sources have told me that this cyborg fugitive was given a VIP invitation to the...
A what?
VIP invitation?
And invited guests of yours, Your Majesty. Do you refute that claim?
I do not refute the claim. I met Ling Cinder 2 weeks prior to the ball. She was a renowned mechanic here in the city, and I had hired her to fix a malfunctioning android. And yes, I did invite her to the ball as a personal guest.
What? When did this happen? It better have happened after Adri dismantled me, because if he asked you to the ball and you didn't tell me...
Aiko, I'm trying to listen.
Did you know she was a cyborg?
I don't see that her being a cyborg is relevant. Next question.
Your Majesty, did you know that she was Lunar when you extended this invitation?
No, of course not. I, naively it seems, was under the impression that there were no Lunars in the Commonwealth. We will be taking additional security measures now to keep Lunars from immigrating here and to find and export any within our borders.
Regarding Her Majesty, Queen Levana, has she or any of the Lunar Corps commented on the escape of the convict?
Oh, she's had a thing or two to say about it. Queen Levana wants Ling Cinder to be found and brought to justice. The word war has been thrown around between Earth and Luna for generations. It is my prerogative to avoid that at all costs. I assure you, I'm doing everything in my power not to unravel our fragile relationship with Luna, starting with finding Ling Cinder. No further questions. Thank you.
They didn't mention me.
Me either.
You're not an escaped convict.
True, but His Majesty and I met once, at the market. I felt like we had a really strong connection. Didn't you think so, Cinder?
I'm a wanted fugitive, too. They do realize I'm missing, don't they?
Maybe they're grateful.
Hey, come back.
I'm busy.
I promise not to make fun of your boyfriend.
He's not my boyfriend.
It's about Michelle Benoit.
What?
She has a teenage granddaughter, Scarlet. But she has no hospital records.
So?
Do you know a single person who wasn't born in a hospital?
Oh, so you think she could be the princess?
She could be.
Well then. Excellent detective work, Captain.
As they searched for trains, Wolf at last began his explanation to Scarlet.
Ren and I were both in the pack sent to retrieve your grandmother. I wasn't with them when she was taken. When we arrived, I saw my chance to escape. I knew I could disappear there without the grid of the city to find me. So I took it. I could have stopped them. I was stronger than all of them. Could have kept it from happening. I could have warned her or you. But I didn't. I just ran.
And then what? You felt guilty? So you thought you'd follow me around for a while and maybe help out on the farm? Like that would make up for it? Why did they take her? What do they want with her? Well?
They're trying to find Princess Celine.
What?
They believe that your grandmother has information on her whereabouts.
Why would my grandmother... The Lunar Princess is dead!
There's evidence that she survived the fire, and that someone rescued her and brought her to Earth.
Grandma is a farmer. She lived in France her whole life. How would she know anything?
She was in the military before she was a farmer. What if she does know something? Scarlet, Rand said that the assignment has been called off, and he could have only meant the search for the princess. I can't imagine why, after so many years, but... If it's true, then it may mean they have no more use of your grandmother.
We have to stop them. We have to go. Now.
Scarlet, the best thing for your grandmother is to be useful. Even if they have stopped looking for Celine, there may still be something she knows, or something in her past. Anything that would make her valuable to them. If you have any information, it's the best chance you have of saving her. You can barter for her with information.
I don't know what they want.
Think. Anything at all related to Lunars.
She has nothing to do with Lunars.
That is not true.
What are you talking about?
She must have told you that she's been to Luna.
You're insane. Why would my grandmother have been to Luna?
She was part of the only diplomatic mission to be sent from Earth to Luna in the last 50 years. She was the pilot. She never told you this?
No, she's never told me any of this. When was this? Wolf, when was this?
40 years ago. 9 months before your father was born.
My father?
Evidence suggests that Celine was taken off Luna by Dr. Logan Tanner, a Lunar. The only Earthians he had contact with were the ones on that trip. And Michelle had a son, with no record of a father. 9 months later.
But we don't keep secrets.
They believe Dr. Tanner asked your grandmother for assistance when he brought the princess down to Earth. That's why they took her.
But did they ever consider that maybe she doesn't know anything?
They're convinced she does. Scarlet, it's in her best interest and yours to give them something.
About Princess Celine?
Yes.
I don't know anything.
A train's coming.
Are you gonna let me jump on my own this time?
Do you want to?
No.
Climb on.
Thank you for telling me everything.
I should have told you sooner.
Yes, you should have. But I still don't despise you.
They landed hard. Very hard. He landed on top of her.
I'm sorry, I'm so sorry, I slipped. Are you alright?
I'm alright, but... You're bleeding.
Scarlet found herself pinned beneath his gaze, intense and terrified. When he didn't move, Scarlet leaned forward and kissed him softly, just once. Then he was pulling her toward him and bundling her up in his arms. Scarlet gasped as Wolf buried one hand into her mess of curls and kissed her back.